Hey!
I open the door. They both jump out. So I pick up Danko and put him back in the car. Hudson gets back in the car.
Who that?
So are you going on an adventure with Kyle? You can make sure you have a rope. Just in case.
Where did I put it?
Are you excited? Are you excited? Oh, yes. Yes.
Are you ready, Hood?
So Hooter and I were off on another little adventure. This time we were headed north into New Hampshire to Lake Winnepesaukee for what was really a work trip, but would end up being a really fun escape. And the day I left happened to be the same day that Simon and his girlfriend Taylor were heading back west for the winter. So I stopped to say goodbye.
Good luck with everything.
Thank you.
Love you, brother.
Love you too.
What a good time.
Truly. Like,
top notch.
And then with the wind in our whiskers, we went off through the fire of fall. And some of my favorite local places that take longer to turn were finally at peak foliage. I wasn't really sure what to expect up in New Hampshire. I had a feeling that the foliage would be past because it's so far north. At the cabin, it was dark, so I didn't know what kind of color we were going to wake up to. And after an early night, I was jumping up and down at the fact that the foliage up here was peak. It was some of the best color I've ever seen. And so I spent the morning filming all around the cabin. It was overcast and a little gloomy, which made the color rich and vibrant. The reason I was up here was I was working on a project for a local company called Winnie's Socks. They're these quirky looking things you see on my feet right here. A longtime supporter of mine named Kara started the company up here in Lake Winnepesaukee, and she's very passionate about it. So when she reached out to me about a year ago and asked if I'd be interested in making some content for her, I was all ears. I enjoy working for passionate people who really believe in what they're doing, as opposed to doing a commercial project just for the money. So this has been a long time coming, and I was excited to bring it to fruition. Kara booked this cabin for me and Hudson and made this whole video possible. And I was in focused filmmaking mode, determined to do a really good job for her. So I was scouting out the whole property, soaking in all the little details, and waiting for Kara to arrive so I could interview her and hear her whole story. The place was called Sunset Lodges, and I happened to be the only one there. And that made for a very peaceful morning.
I love wearing thick, cozy slipper socks. I know when I would spend time at Lake Winnepesaukee in New Hampshire, I would wear slipper socks and I would get frustrated every time I needed to go outside and I'd have to take them off because they're thick and cozy and they don't fit any boots or shoes by the door. So I thought there has to be a better way. So I developed a slipper sock that attaches to an oversock sole. So now you can wear your slipper socks indoors and outdoors. So your feet always stay cozy and your socks stay clean. I'm Kara, I'm the founder of Winnie Socks, and right now it's a one-woman show. So what's unique about Winnie's socks is they actually have a magnet on the back of the sock that you don't even feel when it's on. It comes with an oversock sole, so you don't even have to bend down. You just step on a tab on the back of the sole and you can just slip your foot in, go out and about, and then just do the same thing when you come back inside. So 10% of all proceeds goes towards sending children to summer camp. Winnie's was founded here at Lake Winnepesaukee. I spent a lot of time here with my niece and nephew, and I love seeing them just enjoying nature and they're not on technology, and I wanted to give back. I sent two children to go to camp this past summer, and I hope to send a lot more children moving forward. I get a lot of people who are dog owners. I've had people who actually wear them on airplanes, college students as well. You know, they're always lounging around in the universities in their dorms and they need to go out and do laundry down the hall or go down to the bathroom. Or I've had people tell me, oh my gosh, these are perfect for when I have to go to the chicken coop. It's a wide range of needs on why people use them. You have good days and you have bad days, right? I mean, when you're an entrepreneur, if you have an idea or a small business, there's a lot of days that are self-doubt, but the days when somebody, you show them the product and they use the product and they can relate to it and they say, oh my gosh, I get it. I mean, there's nothing like it. So I've been following Kyle for, gosh, I would say a couple of years now, and I just loved his page. I mean, it was all about cozy New England, and I loved his storytelling, and I reached out to him probably about a year ago, and he believed in the product as well, and you know, being a New England brand. And so here we are now on Lake Winnepesaukee at a beautiful cabin. It's pretty amazing. You know, I'm a Patreon, I'm a damn good kid. So it's great to be able to support his dreams, and he's helping to kind of support my dreams and just partnering together. And I'm excited to see what the future holds.
So after I interviewed Kara, she showed me some cool local spots, and Hudson and I did some more exploring.
Come on, Hud.
And Hudson even climbed his first tower.
Come on, Hud. Holy smokes. Come on, Hud.
And the rain just made the whole experience cozier. Was beautiful. Gorgeous old houses and cabins and stone walls. All the things I love. And this one cabin with the Dodge in front reminded me of Mason. His Dodge has been sitting all summer with no engine, and at this point in October, he was on the brink of being back up and running. And as we went to check out the nearby town, the sky started to clear up a bit. Mist rolled over the mountains in the distance. I've said it before, but I just absolutely love towns like this. Character-rich vacation spots that quiet down on the off-season. It always makes me think about how I'm just passing through and getting a small dose of the place, and to someone else, it's their everything. A place they've been coming their whole life and building memories. I can feel the stories when I'm in a place like this. And so after a full day of filming, it was finally my favorite time of the day to capture. Blue hour. And so Hudson and I moseyed around taking pictures and videos, and most importantly, a few deep breaths, taking time to appreciate how beautiful of an experience this is, and how much I truly do love my job. The fact I get to make movies for a living and work with wholesome people and companies is a dream. It's not without its stresses, just like every other job out there, but it really is my dream, and I always try and take time to reflect on that. Because it's easy to get caught up in the negatives that happen behind the scenes. Life is always going to keep moving no matter what. The thing that's constantly shifting is your perspective on it. It's almost like your mood any given day. Some days when you wake up, you just know it's going to be an off day, and that's okay. But I try and keep a balance of focusing on the good and staying grateful, while still acknowledging the bad and facing it head on. And when I'm back home and editing and doing mundane back-end business stuff all the time, I tend to get caught up in a routine, and it's not until I take trips like this and shake things up that I get back into that reflection mode and remember how good things are. And so on our last morning there, Hudson and I went for a paddle.
Come on, right in here.
here. Up here, Huddy. Up here. Good boy.
After a beautiful couple of days up here, it was time to head home and get back to work on the cabin. So it was late October and a lot of the color was gone, though there were still some pockets left. The oaks turned last like they always do, and the hills were rust-colored, the final phase before they go bare. And on the ride home, I pulled over a few times to film, knowing it would be some of the last foliage footage for the season. John at the local quarry to pick out the final stones for our retaining wall and staircase down to the cabin. The driveway build was nearly done, and the hectic rush of fall was coming to an end. And as we stood there overlooking the hills and the last of the foliage, I thought to myself how excited I was for the first snow, and for everything to slow down for a while.
Now, what do they do with all that?